We are beginning tonight with a tragedy in Santa Cruz County. One woman is dead after a wrong-way driver slammed into her car at the Fish Hook in Santa Cruz. And now, authorities say the crash may have been intentional. They're charging the driver with murder. It happened where Highway 1 and 17 come together. The CHP says the driver was behind a silver SUV intentionally going the wrong way on northbound 17 when he slammed head-on into another car, killing the driver instantly. Action News reporter Stephanie Truong is live in Santa Cruz with more.
The driver of the SUV is a 29-year-old man from Soquel. Now, investigators say it was a premeditated crash, though they're still trying to determine why he did it. ...29-year-old Eric Weirs of Soquel didn't even seem shaken up as he sat in a CHP patrol car just minutes after he killed someone in what investigators are calling an intentional crash. A 49-year-old Santa Cruz woman died after Weirs crashed into her maroon sedan head-on. He was driving north on the southbound lanes of Highway 17 in this silver Acura SUV at the notorious Fish Hook where 17 turns into Highway 1. His SUV caught fire, but Weirs escaped unscathed. CHP investigators say the victim was a random target.
All of a sudden, my driver does, oh my God.
Jesse Houts says he almost died. Houts, who suffers from muscular dystrophy, was in a car right behind the victims.
I see this silver SUV coming straight at us, super fast, like 50 miles an hour. He's swerving all over the road.
The CHP says Weirs was swerving not to avoid collisions, but to try and hit someone.
It was going so fast, and it was hard to imagine how someone could, you know, make that mistake unless he was drunk or high or crazy. That was all we could think.
Police still don't know what the motive was. According to Weirs' Facebook page, he graduated from Soquel High School and Cabrillo College and changed his profile picture on July 1st. Little else is known. In the meantime, Houts says his thoughts are with the victim's family.
If we had left for when we left, you know, 15 seconds later, it would have been us. But luckily it wasn't, and I feel very lucky to be alive.
Now, firefighters had to be called out to the scene to put out that SUV fire, and traffic was backed up for hours, this happening during the peak commute hours. Again, this has turned into a murder case, with police still trying to figure out what motivated Weirs to do this. Dan?
All right. Thank you very much, Stephanie. The driver, Eric Weirs, is facing multiple charges, including murder, vehicular manslaughter with gross negligence, assault with a deadly weapon, and driving the wrong way on the highway.